Hi there, everyone. Welcome to SCBTV's The Dose, presented by Sweet Spot Smiles, and we're excited you are with us. And of course, we're putting the spotlight on the healthcare industry in your backyard. And I'm so excited right now to be here on location at Eagles Landing OBGYN in Stockbridge with the one and only OBGYN, Dr. Christine Smith-Winfield. Welcome to The Dose.
Thank you. Glad to be here.
Excited to have you on. Now, we're today going to focus on an area that you know a lot about, but a lot of us maybe not so much, talking about pregnancy. Many of us have seen, of course, pregnant women around, out and about. Maybe some of you watching are planning for a pregnancy or just gave birth to a child. But I know you say there's so much more to it, that actually there is a wellness component that we very much need to be aware of, such as weight during pregnancy.
Definitely. You know, as we're talking about weight in pregnancy, women need to be aware of what their BMI is prior to giving birth. BMI is your weight divided by your height, or kilograms divided by meter squared.
Okay.
Based on what your BMI is when you first get pregnant, that determines how much weight you can gain in pregnancy. For women who start off with a normal BMI less than 25, the goal is that you can gain anywhere between 25 and 35 pounds. Now, if you're more in the overweight, then we start looking more closely at how much weight you can gain. And then when you're obese, we're looking at less than 20 pounds for your pregnancy. So it really does determine based on how much you weigh prior to getting pregnant.
So, okay, doctor, there's someone right now, you know, that's watching us from Butts County saying, well, wait a minute. As my grandmother and mother said, I'm eating for two.
Yeah.
So how are you going to hold me to the constraint of those pounds?
That is a very good question. I definitely get asked that every day. You know, you're not eating for two.
Okay.
I would like to say you're eating for 1 1/4, okay?
I see.
Babies are very small. They don't need any extra. But with that being said, you know, it's not only important to watch what you eat, but it's also important to make sure that you keep a healthy weight and exercise during pregnancy as well.
Wow, and talking about a diet, okay, let's focus on that right now. I know you've shared previously that it's not necessarily okay to say, well, I ate this food all of my life. I've done these habits. You're saying it's time to really get serious about the food we're taking in, especially because there's someone else inside, right?
Exactly. You know, it's not only important to watch what you eat, but the amount that you
eat.
You know, avoiding the carbs, especially if you're starting out with a BMI over 30.
Okay.
You want to make sure that you're eating a nice, balanced, healthy meal, and then also that you're exercising 3 times a week that is safe from pregnancy for 30 minutes.
I know weight continues to come up throughout this health show. So many of the experts like you have brought it up. I know weight with women can also really correlate with a type of diabetes that pregnant women can get. Explain.
Definitely. So there's two types of diabetes. One, as you described, prior to you being pregnant, and then one in pregnancy. If you're diagnosed with diabetes in pregnancy, it's called gestational diabetes. Okay. And we have to watch you more closely. You'd be considered a high-risk pregnancy, and it's very important to monitor what you eat at that point also.
Wow.
We make sure you see a nutritionist, we make sure you see a high-risk doctor, and we monitor your pregnancy more closely.
I see. So it's important to stay on track of all of that.
Oh, definitely, definitely.
Now, see, so when you visit an expert like yourself, then they can get diagnosis. Hopefully everything will be healthy.
Yeah.
But if not, you can address those concerns. So sometimes individuals may say that, well, I started going to the OBGYN at the beginning of the pregnancy, but in between, not so much, right? I'm going to come back towards the end of the birth.
Yeah.
But you shared it is so important to continue or to keep all of your appointments because it's a great way to diagnose potential problems or risks.
Definitely. You know, everybody, when they come to the doctor, especially in OBGYN, they want to hear the heartbeat.
Yes.
We want to hear the heartbeat with you. It's an exciting moment, especially when you're either starting your family or expanding your family.
Yes.
But we're also checking other things. We're making sure that the baby is measuring appropriately.
Okay.
Like you said, we're screening you for anemia, whether or not you need iron during your pregnancy.
Okay.
We're screening you for diabetes. Every time you come in, we also check your blood pressure.
Okay.
Make sure you're not developing something called preeclampsia, which is blood pressure issues in pregnancy. Making sure that the baby is growing the right way, making sure your weight gain is appropriate. We're doing the gamut of everything during it. It seems like we're only checking the baby's heartbeat, but we're actually taking a pulse of you and your baby.
Wow, and that's so important.
It
because
definitely
you're treating
is.
The mother and the child.
We are.
Right? And I know when we talk about family and community and engagement, you also said you welcome the partners or spouses to join in so they can take part of what's going on with the child and family.
Definitely, definitely. I mean, the importance of having a great support system,
yes.
whether that's the father of the baby, your husband, your partner, your family, your mother, your aunt.
Yes.
Everybody in your life has a super important role in not only you being a great mom, but also they have tons of advice for you about, you know, what to expect in the pregnancy and how the pregnancy is going. So we definitely welcome the spouses to come. We invite mothers, family members, whoever is your support system, because again, when we give you information, we're also giving it to them.
Yes.
And to go back to what you were saying about the food and weight gain in pregnancy, you know, it's hard if your spouse is the one that cooks for you, and I'm telling you, hey, you shouldn't be eating that much, or, you know, watch the bread, watch the carbs. Sometimes hearing it from a doctor makes it easier for them to also adjust.
Exactly.
I tell everybody the family is watching what they're eating, not just you and the baby.
And I'll go on a ledge and say this, that it also helps the babies have good habits as well.
Exactly.
When the baby comes and grows as a toddler, everybody's on board.
Exactly.
Well, let's talk about that big day, right?
Oh,
when the
yes.
birth is here.
Mm-hmm.
Exciting. There's a lot that goes on in the hospital that you all obviously are leading the way on.
Yeah.
But I know you've shared that once the wife or the woman has that child, that you're saying, though, hey, it's not the end of the treatment plan with her. Explain.
Yeah. So basically, after you give birth, and we're so happy to be a part of that with Eagles Landing, we also want to make sure that you come to your visits afterwards.
Okay.
There's a big push in our society to talk about postpartum depression and also to talk about family planning, and those things can show up after you give birth as well.
Now, for our audience watching us right now, what exactly is postpartum depression?
Thank you for asking. You know, there's a difference between postpartum blues and postpartum depression.
Okay.
Postpartum blues is the normal fluctuation in hormones within the first 2 weeks after you give birth to a baby.
I see.
Postpartum depression is usually after that 2 week period.
Okay.
And women can be sad and depressed, and it's not because they're not happy about having the baby, but they're actually just having depression also related to the pregnancy. So that's postpartum depression.
And that depression, like other forms of depression, is something they cannot control.
They cannot control, and you definitely need to see a doctor about it. We counsel all of our women that if you're having any signs afterwards of feeling sad, having low energy, feeling depressed, that you definitely need to give us a phone call so that we can screen you.
And that's why it's important going back to the whole family unit, because not only maybe that woman not being able to recognize it, but the partner, spouse, or grandmother, or grandfather that are witnessing her with the child, right?
Oh, definitely. I cannot tell you how many times our patients will say, my husband noticed that I'm a little off, and that's usually how they come in. And when we do the screening, they screen positive for postpartum depression. I always tell them, thank you for involving your family. Thank you for involving your spouse, because it also lets us know that there's other people who notice that you're sadder than what you normally are.
Wow. And I know, of course, with the babies here, then you're treating them afterwards. Eagles Landing OBGYN also has a plan for family planning.
Of course. Yes. So let's say you and your partner have decided that you want to space out your children, or you want to have a child in 1 year, or you're finished with child bearing overall. We offer all the services to assist you with that, all the way from pills to IUDs, all the way to permanent sterilization, if that's what you're interested in.
I see. And I know, of course, you all focus on pregnancy here, but also the general wellness of women.
Correct.
As well. So I know you always invite women to come in and really express or speak their mind on different things they may have concerns about.
Right. You know, being a woman is an amazing thing. You know, we have health issues all the way from the beginning, from learning about our bodies, about learning about breast development, to the first time we meet our partner or a guy, and sexual education, all the way to giving birth, and then, you know, all the way after you give birth to when you go into menopause. You know, OBGYN has such a variety and widespread of any part of a woman's life that we can be involved in.
Wow, what an amazing journey.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you for watching us and being educated with me on The Dose. Stay with us.
At Eagles Landing OBGYN, we strive to create a warm and welcoming atmosphere. A place where women of all ages will be comfortable no matter what the reason for their visit. Eagles Landing OBGYN offers a full range of obstetric and gynecological services, all at one location. From FDA-approved 3D digital mammography, AIUM-certified ultrasounds, bone density scans, urinary incontinence therapy, pelvic health therapy, lab services, infertility, pregnancy care, menopause treatment, fibroid treatment, bleeding problems, and yearly well woman visits. Our doctors specialize in minimally invasive surgeries, vaginal prolapse, and urogynecology, and much more. Our diverse group of physicians and friendly staff are sure to take care of your every need and more. At Eagles Landing OBGYN, we understand the importance of quality, compassion care. Start the conversation today about your female healthcare needs. Call Eagles Landing OBGYN at 770-474-1919 to schedule an appointment. Visit our website at www.eagleslandingobgyn.com.